Hi, Nick and classmates. The example that I am going to talk about is Mercedes-Benz modeled a car on the box fish. In the mid of 1990s, Mercedes-Benz wanted to design a car, but just any car, and through not just any design approach. Mercedes-Benz sought to design a vehicle that was at once aerodynamic, safe, efficient, and maneuverable, and to achieve all of these goals while drawing from a single overarching theme. Mercedes-Benz turned its gaze to nature for inspiration. After much searching, the company looked to the boss fish, a small tropical coral reef fish, as a model. Unlike just about every other fauna on Earth, box fish are entirely encapsulated in a squarish or triangular, lightweight, rigid bony shell called a carapace, derived entirely from numerous smaller stony plates fused together, looking like a honeycomb that looked ice with medusa. The story of the bossfish swimming paradox and Mercedes-Benz shouldn't be seen as a lesson in looking before the leap, or a condemnation of bionics. Instead, this story illuminates the importance of trade-off and physical constraints in evolution. Living creatures are beholden to the laws of physics and chemistry, and every evolutionary strategy careers with the unavoidable drawbacks and downstream effects. For example, the bird's light bones aid in its flight, but they don't have the load-bearing power of denser ancestral forms. The evolutionary path of power flight has led to sacrifice in other capacities. The boxfish swimming paradox was viewed as such essentially because it involved an egregious violation of this concept of trade-offs, generating a have your cake and eat too. A scenario of adaptation. The boxfish supposedly was a master of stability and maneuverability, even though these skills should come at a direct cost to each other. This vision of both fish swimming and aerodynamic aptitudes despite the attractiveness to the bionics engineering team was simply too good to be true. Thanks for your attention and bye.